Thanks for your patience, everyone, and welcome back to another video. This is my second video from Scotland from a recent trip, and after this one, there maybe is one or maybe two more before I head back to New Zealand to do a New Zealand-based video or from somewhere else, depending on wherever I end up in the world. Now many years ago, when I was just a boy, a character on the island of Hoi called Davy Hatch, he once told me that Orkadians worth their salt would never admit to being Scottish, but Scandinavian. So Scandinavian or Scottish, Scottish or Scandinavian, I'm heading home to Orkney. Now with a deep and rich history between the Orkney Islands and Norway, we can certainly identify with being Scandinavian, but as an island nation, well, we're unique. And I'm heading home, travelling from Skrabster to my hometown of Strumness, by boat that, to me, will always be remembered as the Ola. And every time I come round the point of Ness here, I remember or get reminded that this place gets under your skin. Now, an archipelago of 75 islands with just 23,000 people. Well, we Orkadians, we make this place what it is. But this place makes us who we are. And I'm home for just 5 days to try and take some lovely photographs and videography of this beautiful and historic part of the British Isles. Sit back and enjoy a small peek of everything that this place has got to offer. Welcome to Orkney. Now this is Orkney, and Orkney sits at 59 degrees north, and significantly this is actually in the same latitude as the southern tip of Alaska. And so, well, we get our share of the weather. Now this weather is creating a few problems for me, given that I'm only home for a few days, and these last few days have been blown off course. Day 3, and it's still too windy to venture out from the lee of the wind from behind this shed at the Hole of Row. Now, I've always wondered about what is it specifically that makes Orkney landscapes just so beautiful, and I think that its beauty actually lies in its simplicity. It's a landscape that it's low slung with soft, undulating, gentle shapes. Low in profile and almost like it's hunkering down to get out of the wind and out of the way of the weather. The weather scrubs this land clean, but its spirit remains. And never a truer word has been said. In stark contrast to much of Orkney, this is the island of Hoi, and probably one of my favourite places in Orkney. On the right there, well, that's actually the Kame of Hoi, and a well-known and prominent landmark to Orkadians. This landmass can be seen from much of the mainland of Orkney and further afield too, as well as it being a directional reference for Orkadians. Well, Strumnessians, people from Strumness, also have a sundial that they can use as a clock, but it doesn't need the sun. And that's the ferry. We can set our clock by this thing usually. And this is the lifeblood of Orkney, bringing Orcadians home, tourists, logistics, freight and supplies in. And a characteristic I remember as a child is the daily newspapers used to arrive by boat. And the Sunday newspaper, well, that used to arrive on the Monday. But if the sea was rough, then it was a Tuesday. Now I'm going to take the passenger ferry to Hoy. That's not the ferry, I'm not sure I'd even go to sea in that. The passenger ferry affords a unique look at my hometown of Strumness and allows you to observe its strong connection with the sea from this low perspective. And these houses built in the 1400s have their gable ends to the sea with small windows for protection. Now this building style is just one of the cues to Orkney's history with Norway. This island here, this is the island of Gramsay, and there are two lights here, Hoy High, and this one is Hoy Low. You'll just see to the right of picture here, there's a lookout tower and a gun embattlement reminding us of Orkney's strategic role in both World War I and World War II, and a further reminder of Orkney's landscape peppered with remnants of artifacts during that turbulent time. And as well as recent history, well, Orkney has some spectacular history with World Heritage sites smattered all over the place from the Stone Age and Neolithic periods. These places are 5,000 years old. So this is Rackwick Bay, and Rackwick's a bay on the kind of southwest side, I think it is, of the island of Hoy. And Hoy is Latin for High Island. And these are the big massive sandstone cliffs here. I'm just going to zoom in here for you. I'll try and lighten it off so we can see the separation. Wrong way. There we are. See the separation between the two different headlands here. And these are red sandstone cliffs. And they're pretty big, as you can see. And as they disintegrate and fall apart, it creates a quite unusual beach here to the left, to my left. And I don't know if you can see it here. Let's just darken it for you. That there is the mainland of Scotland. So we're about 20 miles, I think, from the mainland of Scotland to Orkney, across the Pentland Firth, part of the North Sea. So these here are the big massive sandstone boulders, which are round in shape because of the tumbling in the sea. It's a really rough bay, this. And swimming is not advised in Rackwick. And we can see on these rocks the kind of sedimentary nature of them. I zoom in to let you see this. And they're really quite cool. And they're part of the bay of Rackwick, and the other side of the bay looks like this. Again, a big dramatic face of sandstone rock. And this is the path to the Old Man of Hoy, which is Britain's largest vertical rock stack. And away up in the distance here, a house with a view. It's the house, or the ex-house, of Sir Peter Maxwell Davis, who was a world famous composer. And as I say, he looks across. And this view here. Lucky, lucky, lucky. So this is the Bothy in Rackwick. It's a tiny little traditional stone cottage with a flagstone roof and an open fireplace, which is open to be used by people
who are travelling around the world and who will respect it. And at the sign of the times, I guess, but there's actually a notice board in here. And sadly it says, due to some people burning the chairs, the wardens will be down every day, and anyone caught doing so will be asked to leave the property and pay for any damage. Idiots.
No, I'm trying to get to the end of the beach here in Rackwick, and either this lady knows better than I do, in which case I know nothing, or I know better than she does and she shouldn't be in there. And I'm watching her here, just how she falls into the waves here. And you just watch the speed that she gets dragged to the left. Oh, I'm looking away.
Now the light's not right today. But when you look back in your summer snaps from your parents or grandparents, very rarely was the light right, which is why I'm taking this today. Rackwick's a funny place in that it always seems to be sunny in Rackwick. And this is what I'm trying to capture here in a way that I remember it from my youth. Now, after a few days of having been rained off and blown off, I've got the camera out today in Rackwick, and to avoid running the risk of undoing or contradicting everything I've said about what to shoot, what not to shoot, and making sure that we don't complicate a scene by having foreground interest, the island of Hoy or Rackwick plays a special part in my mind's memory, because we used to holiday here every summer with my grandmother, and we used to spend several weeks, and the biggest part of enjoyment was often looking at the old Polaroid photographs after we were finished, and they were square photographs with a narrow white border and usually quite teal in colour cast. So what I'm wanting to do is just try and recapture that. It's how my mind sees this scene, as having a square Polaroid type photograph but shot with the Pentax. And I'm looking out here across rocks, pools. I just showed you that really green sea moss that was on the rocks here a little while ago, and I'm wanting to try and include that in the bottom of the frame. And I'm only including that in the bottom of the frame as that's how the old Polaroids would have been taken. They would have always had a square format, quite wide, but this is being shot with an 80 to 160 mil lens. So I'm going to focus on the cliffs way in the distance and probably throw this stuff in the foreground out of focus a little bit, but the colour will still come through in the foreground, and then when I'm finished it, I'll finish it off with a narrow white border like I would do or would have in an old Polaroid photograph. So please don't roll your eyes and say tut tut you and you're undoing everything you've said about no composition not being important. The hero piece, for me, the hero piece here probably is both the cliffs but also the memory of this place when I was a child. So I'm going to take this two shot vertical panel shot at 80 millimeters, f11, no filtration, 100 ISO at about 60th of a second. And the unusual thing for me today too is that I'm actually using my eyepiece. Right, that's the light meter test taken and confirming we are at a 60th of a second. I'm going to go down to F13 at 60th, 100 ISO. Focused on the cliffs, foreground out of focus, 50% overlap, and the tiniest bit more just to get the other side of that pond in. Beautiful place.
These are some massive cliffs here, and I remember seeing these as a child and thinking, it's a normal thing to see. But this isn't normal. This is impressive. And it's this gentle humility that makes Orkney what it is.
Now, I'm going to take a photograph of St. John's Head. And St. John's Head is the highest vertical cliff face in the British Isles. Now I think I'm about 500 feet up here, and I'm not a pussy, but I'm trying to get quite low with the shot. And again, I'm going to shoot this with my handheld, no tripod, and looking through the eyepiece. And I'm actually going to take the far off cliff as my focus piece. And I'm just going to introduce some grasses and moss again at the bottom of the frame. Not for foreground interest, but to show that there's such a landmass here behind my shot. So let me just start off with the left-hand frame where there's a big rock face in the foreground. And I'm shooting this here at f/13/60th of a second, but I'm going to take it down a little bit actually. I'll take it down to an 80th of a second, because it's just a little bit bright. Really down low, introduce the green, click, and again, 50% overlap, and 50% overlap. And that takes me out past the edge of the cliff. I'm just gonna go over here to see the Old Man of Hoy, which is about 100 meters to my left. And as I say, the British Isles vertical stack, the tallest vertical stack of rock. I can't spend too long here because I think I'm going to miss the boat at this rate. And this is the edge here, close to Old Man of Hoy. And I've got to watch that I don't slip. That there is the bottom. And bringing you to the top. I'm not quite sure if that's somebody on top of there having climbed, or if it's rock stacks. Quite an incredible feat, and one day it will of course fall over. Just looking at this area of cliff here, this is quite overhanging, and we can see in here just how unstable these rocks at the top are. But I'm going to go and lie on the top of this and take a photograph back towards the Old Man of Hoy. But I'll actually have the wind in my face up there, and so probably can't vlog.
Returning to these more modest landscapes after the madness of the large cliffs in Rackwick and on the west side, it's familiar to be looking at these views now with its unique colours of Orkney and its agriculture. And as I wait at Moness Pier, having recovered a microphone I dropped into the sea, we're waiting on the lifeblood of these islands, the ferry service.
I'm so glad you found it, and man, it'd be awesome if it still works.
It does, and I'm lucky. It was careless of me to drop it, but I'm tired. It's been a long day.
There we are, down to 13%.
and I'll never tire of looking at these gentle, relaxing landscapes. Orkney is beautiful.
These anemones, when underwater, are bright fire red. Really cool.
Thanks for watching, everyone, wherever you are. You have a good week, take care, you keep shooting, have fun, and until the next video, which won't be far away, I promise. Cheerio.